Hey, greetings, greetings, wonderful saints, in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I hope I find you well this evening. Hey, it's our midweek service, and we've had a great 3 days of prayer as Mana Tabernacle, our last quarter prayer. And it has been so awesome. It has come with a lot of revelations, a lot of teachings that our pastor was opening our eyes to see. And I'm going to labor around those even this evening. And I greet you all, sons and daughters of Mana Tabernacle, our friends on Facebook, I greet you all. Our fans on YouTube, I greet you also in the name that is above every name, the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I hope you are all well. I hope you are doing well. Hey, Bazalwane, we are closing the year and we are closing strong. We are closing with power. We are closing with power and strength. I hope you are ready to close strong, Mzalwane. And let me take this opportunity to appreciate this opportunity that I've been given by our spiritual parents, Pastor Strike and Pastor Joeline, to come to your homes this evening. Hey, and hey, I do not take it for granted. I do not take it lightly, but I really appreciate it. And thank you, my brothers and sisters. We are going to have a great time tonight. We are going to be sharing the word of God, encouraging each other as we close this year. And we will find our scripture reading from the book of Romans chapter 8, and we are reading from verse 11, and it reads as follows. But if the spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, he who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies through his spirit which dwells in you. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you, Father, for the reading of your word. My God, we thank you. And my Father, here I am, and I say, Jehovah, as we're going to share on this word, Holy Spirit of my Father, may you think through my mind and speak through my lips as you are going to strengthen us, as you are going to position us, as you are going to correct us, as you are going to align us as we close this year. Thank you, Spirit of the living God, in the name that is above every name, the name of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. Hey, thank you, Bazalwane. Thank you so much. Yes, we've been having a great time of prayer as Mana Tabernacle, our prayer of fasting in these past 3 days, and it has been awesome. And I hope you have had a great time. And I have been so encouraged because our pastor made us realize that we have crossed over, especially as a church, to the other side, and also as a nation, as you come to realize that we are now on level one. We are no longer on those critical levels, but we have crossed over to the other side. And what does that say to us? It says when Jesus crossed over with the disciples to the other side, when they encountered a storm, they crossed over to the other side. And when they made it after the storm, hey, it's amazing what our pastor showed us, Pastor Joeline. It's amazing to realize that when they had crossed over to the other side, when God had given them so much victory, it was important that they realize the victory. They realized the abundance that lied ahead. And when they had gone over to the other side, the Bible says that when they got into the other side, to the region of the Gennesarites, they came across this man. They met with this man, Legion, the man that was, you know, full of demons, and that man was liberated. And I look at all that and I say that out of the storm, out of the difficulty of the storm, when they land on the other side, they realize that, you know what, there is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in what Jesus could do. And I want to say to you, Mzalwane, there is power in the name of Jesus Christ. We have made it across to the other side, not by power, not by might, but by him we have made it to the other side. Just like the disciples, they said, Master, don't you care that we perish? And they crossed over to the other side, because Jesus calmed the storm for them. And I want to say to you, Mzalwane, you have made it to the other side. You have made it across, Mzalwane, across the storm. Many people, Mzalwane, did not make it. Many people, Mzalwane, went through difficulty in this storm. But I want to say to you, Mzalwane, you might have gone through the difficulty of contracting COVID-19. You might have gone through the difficulty of losing your family members. But I want to say to you, Mzalwane, listening to me today, I want to say to you, you have made it to the other side. Mzalwane, you have made it to the other side, and that calls for us to praise the Lord. That calls for us to give God the glory. And tonight, Mzalwane, I want to encourage you and say to you, Mzalwane, be aware of what the Lord has done. Be aware of the great battle that the Lord has caused you to win. And be anticipating of the great things that are lying ahead, Mzalwane. There is still great things that are lying ahead for me and you. Because when we look at the book of Mark chapter 5, 5 and Mark chapter 6, we realize that when they had gone over to the other side, after they liberated the man, because that was a victorious moment to liberate a man that had been infested with demons. That was a moment of testimony. That was a moment of victory, Mzalwane. And they went on. We see Jairus' daughter being healed. We see the lady, the woman with the issue of blood, being healed. And we see the feeding of the 5,000. All these miracles, they follow up after the storm. And I want to say to you, Mzalwane, the storm is over with us right now. But God wants you to live the life ahead of the storm. God wants you to realize the life ahead of the storm. And that is a life of victory. That is a life of power, Mzalwane. That is a life to overcome. God wants you to realize that we might not have closed the year as people have closed the year. If people have communicated and say, hey, the year is over, God wants you, Mzalwane, to realize that the year is not over. He has got great and awesome plans for you. He has got great and awesome miracles that are lined up for you. But the Bible says that only an anticipating heart shall be rewarded. I want to say to you, Mzalwane, this is a time to anticipate of the goodness of the Lord. This is a time to anticipate of the greatness of the Lord. We cannot sit down and say, hey, the year is finished. I want to say to you, Mzalwane, God wants to bless you. God wants to prosper you. But you need to stand up, Mzalwane. You need to get yourself up, Mzalwane, and be ready to go on and be ready to fight, Mzalwane. You need to stand up and not even undermine the 2 fishes and the 5 loaves that you have. But look unto the Lord. The Lord wants to multiply those few fish that you have, those few loaves that you have. God wants to multiply them in this time, Mzalwane. And I want to say to you, as we have read from the book of Romans, Mzalwane, do not lose heart. The Bible says that the same power that rose Christ from the dead is at work in you. The same power that God used for you to overcome the storm of COVID-19 is at work in you, Mzalwane, to revive your mortal body, to revive your economy, Mzalwane, to revive your family, Mzalwane. That power, Mzalwane, is made available. That power, Mzalwane, is within you. But you need to stand up, Mzalwane. You see, when God says to Isaac, do not go down to Egypt. Hey, I will bless you here. Isaac does not sit down and say, I am waiting for a blessing. But the Bible says that Isaac plowed and Isaac sowed a seed. And the Bible says that he reaped 100%. And I want to say to you, Mzalwane, when the Lord says it's not over, when the Lord says he's got a blessing for you, it is the time to rise up and realize what is it that you have in this season. Because God wants to multiply it. As our Lord Jesus said to the disciples, what are you going to give these people? What is it that you have? And they said, no, we only have, 2 fish and 5 loaves. I want to say to you, Mzalwane, God is saying to you, what is it that you have? What is it that you are carrying? You might be looking at the year and say that the year is gone down. The year is finished. I want to say to you, Mzalwane, the year is not finished. When Jesus spoke to the disciples, he said, okay, make people sit down. And the Lord blessed those fish and and that bread and said, give it to the people. I want to say to you, Mzalwane, same applies with you. You might be looking back right now and you are saying the year is over. You might be wrapping up whatever you're wrapping up, saying, no, it's over. It's done. You might be, like the disciples, Peter and James and John, when they're done with their fishing. You might be like them when they were washing their nets and thinking it's over. I want to say to you, Mzalwane, it is not over. I want to say to you, Mzalwane, God has a great plan. I was encouraged by the message of our pastor when he shared the message that he sent over to our phones. I was encouraged to realize that after the storm, there was so much victory. After the storm, there was so much power. And I want to say to you, Mzalwane, there is so much power for you. The same power that rose Christ from the dead, that power, Mzalwane, is available for you in these last few months. phansi mzalwane. I want to say to you, no eye has seen, no ear heard what the Lord has prepared for you, mzalwane. But you need to stand up like we see with Isaac. Isaac did not sit down, but he went on to do what he knew best. And what he knew best was to plow and to sow a seed. And the Bible says he reaped 100%. And I want to say to you, mzalwane, God wants you to reap 100% in these few months. But you need to know that you are blessed. You need to know that God has got something great for you. You need to realize what God has made available for you and get down to business. In the name of Jesus Christ, whatever you shall do, mzalwane, God wants to bless. God wants to prosper, mzalwane. The door is open. Pastor Mkwena has been sharing with us, and he has been telling us that, hey, now it's time to dial direct, to call the Lord. There is a highway for us, mzalwane. There is a highway for you, mzalwane. In the blood of Jesus Christ, there is a highway, mzalwane, for us. The curtain has been torn 2,000 years ago. There is a highway for me and you, mzalwane, that is available. But we need to use that highway. We need to use that way, mzalwane. If we do not use it, mzalwane, we will remain the same. If we do not use it, mzalwane, we will share and talk the same language as everybody out there. But if we tell ourselves that the Lord says there is something great for us, that the Lord says there is something that he has prepared for us in this last month of the year, I'm telling you, mzalwane, you will see great things. And our pastor said that the Lord has prepared great things for us. But we need to anticipate, mzalwane. We need to change the way we see things. We need to change the way we look at things. And he was encouraging us, reminding that us that, you know what, we have been praying throughout this COVID-19 months, of these 6 months that have passed. We have been praying, mzalwane, but our prayer has been centered around fear, because we needed protection, because we were asking the Lord, say, protect us. Our prayer has been like the prayer of the disciples when they said to Jesus, don't you care that we perish? But they had to come to a point that their prayer changes. They had to come to a point that they realize that they've had victory, and there is more victory around Jesus. And I want to say to you, mzalwane, you are victorious. You have overcome the enemy. You have overcome the storm. But it doesn't end there, mzalwane. God has a great blessing that he has lined up for you. God has a great blessing, mzalwane. But you need to acknowledge the change of season. You need to acknowledge, mzalwane, and accelerate yourself and change your prayer, mzalwane. And change your prayer, mzalwane. And expect the miracles of the Lord. You know, the Bible says that in the book of Acts chapter 12, when they were praying for Peter, and Peter had been arrested, and Peter and others were arrested, they prayed. The Bible says that they gathered in the house and they prayed. They prayed. And when Peter came and knocked at the door, and the young girl Rhoda went to the door to open the door, and as she found that Peter was there, she closed the door and ran back to them and to tell them that Peter is there. What did they say? What did the saints say? They said, no, you have seen a ghost. You have not seen Peter. I want to say to you, mzalwane, let us be careful, because we may pray and pray and not even hear when the Lord is answering. We must pray and have our ears opened to hear the Lord, our eyes open to see what God is doing, to see the change of season. And I want to say to you, mzalwane, we have prayed and prayed and cried for protection. It is time to pray and ask for all the blessings of the Lord in terms of his abundance, because you know our pastors have been sharing and saying, what is it that you have? It means in the midst of the storm that we have been in the midst of the storm that we are coming out of, God wants to bless us. God wants to prosper us. God wants to elevate us, mzalwane. God wants to do a new thing for me and you. But you need to realize that. You need to know who you are. That's why Paul in Romans 8:11 says, but the Spirit that raised Christ from the dead is at work in you. He is reminding us that the same Spirit, the same powerful Spirit that denied death, the same powerful Spirit that denied an impossible situation and raised Christ from the dead, that Spirit Mzalwane is in me and you. And that Spirit is ready to propel our mortal bodies. But we need to acknowledge the presence of that Spirit. We need to acknowledge the presence of the work of that Spirit in our lives, Mzalwane, in this season. And understand that this is a time of miracle. And understand that this is a time of great things. And understand that this is a time where God wants to lift us up, where God wants to prosper us. We see the Jairus' daughter being raised up. We see the woman with the issue of blood who had lost everything in Mzalwane, who had struggled for years. We see her being raised up in Mzalwane. I want to say to you, Lord Mzalwane, the Lord wants to raise you. The Lord wants to prosper you in these past few months, Mzalwane. You might be like the woman with the issue of blood, having lost things over the past few months, thinking that it's over. And I want to say to you, Mzalwane, like the woman with the issue of blood, if you only you make a decision and say, if only you make a decision and say, if only I can touch the hem of his garment. And I want to say to you, Mzalwane, touch the hem of the garment of the master by faith. Touch the hem of the garment of the master by faith. And Mzalwane, you are going to see great and wonderful things. You are going to see liberation. And the Bible says that when they touched the hem of his garment, Jesus restored. She was restored in health. And Jesus commanded restoration in her life. She said, and everything that you have lost may it be restored. Only, Mzalwane, if you acknowledge the season that has changed, you acknowledge the power of the resurrection that is at work in you, you acknowledge, Mzalwane, that we are across the storm and we are going, we are closing this year, and we are closing this year with power, we are closing this year with strength, you are closing this year, Mzalwane, to overcome. But you need to acknowledge that, Mzalwane. You need to acknowledge that the power that rose Christ from the dead is at work in you. Because that power, Mzalwane, nothing can stop that power. Absolutely nothing can stop that power. But you need to acknowledge it. You need to realize it, Mzalwane. You need to be aware of that Spirit that is at work in you, Mzalwane. You cannot be talking the language, Mzalwane, of people out there who are saying it's over, let this year end. We want to start 2021. Some that are saying, hey, let 2020 be cancelled as if it never existed. Hey, I want to say to you, Mzalwane, do not be part of those people. Do not be part of that conversation, Mzalwane. Do not be part of that conversation, because a greater God who says no eye has seen what he has prepared for you, no ear heard what God has prepared for you who love him. I'm telling you, Mzalwane, do not lose your blessing by teaming up with people that do not understand your God. Do not lose your blessing, Mzalwane, by teaming up with people that do not understand the power of the resurrection that is at work in you. But Mzalwane, stand up and speak the word of God. For you are blessed in the city. You are blessed in the country. You are blessed coming in. You are blessed going out. And I want to say to you, Mzalwane, the Lord has blessed us. The Lord has brought us this far for a reason. And we are going to finish this year with a powerful testimony, Mzalwane. We are going to finish this year, Mzalwane, on that podium of victory. But you need to understand who you are. You need to understand, Mzalwane, who you are. That there is power, the same Spirit, that powerful Spirit that defied death, that powerful Spirit that defied the plan of the enemy to raise our Lord to life, is at work in you, Mzalwane. You are not destined to be poor. You are not destined to fail. You are not destined, Mzalwane, to be below, but you are destined to be above. To be the head and not the tail, Mzalwane. You are destined, Mzalwane, to be on chariots, not walking on feet, Mzalwane. You are destined for great things, but you need to know who you are. You need to know who you are. And once you know who you are, the words that will come out of your mouth shall be the words of life. The words that will come out of your mouth shall be the words that are embedded in the word of God. But only you need to know, Mzalwane. Only you need to acknowledge. Look at the victory that the Lord has given us throughout this pandemic. Look at that victory and look forward and anticipate the great things and anticipate celebration, anticipate victory, Mzalwane, anticipate great things. Raise the testimony, Mzalwane, of what the Lord has done in these past 6 months, of what the Lord has done during this pandemic, and look forward, Mzalwane. Do not let the season of the pandemic that went through, Mzalwane, determine your way going forward. Do not let it determine. Do not let your language, Mzalwane, be formulated of what you have gone through, Mzalwane. Do not let it be, you know, measured by where you have passed. But let your language, Mzalwane, be the language of what God says. Be the language of the word of God. And I can assure you, Mzalwane, you will rise up to the top. You will make it to the top, Mzalwane. You will sit there, Mzalwane, at the top, Mzalwane, because God wants to create a table for you in the midst of your enemies. Only know who you are. Do not join up with your enemies. Do not join up with defeated men. Do not join up with people that do not know they are God. Because Daniel says that they that know their God, they shall be strong. You must be strong, Mzalwane. You must be strong, Mzalwane, so that you can do exploits. You cannot do exploits, Mzalwane, when you are weak. You need to be strong and rise up and know that the Lord has taken us over to the other side. And to the other side, there is victory. To the other side, there is glory. To the other side, there is power. Know that the Lord has taken us to the other side. You need to know, you need to acknowledge, Mzalwane. You cannot dwell, Mzalwane. You cannot be on the other side. And your mind is dwelling where we were. We are across, Mzalwane. That's why even as Mana Tabernacle, we are now gathering for services. It tells you we are across, Mzalwane. Acknowledge that we are across. Do not let fear determine your future. Do not let fear determine your next step, Mzalwane. We are meeting because we acknowledge what the Lord has done for us. We are meeting because we acknowledge that God has answered our prayers. That's why we are on level one. We acknowledge what the Lord has done. We acknowledge that the Lord has heard our prayers, Mzalwane. But you need to stand up. Otherwise, Mzalwane, your family, your life will remain on level five when you are on level one, Mzalwane. You are on level one. God has brought us this far. By his mighty hand, he has taken us by his mighty hand to bring us to a place of glory. He has taken us by his mighty hand to bring back everything that the cankerworm ate, everything that the enemy stole from you. God has, but you must be standing where you are able to receive that. I hope, Mzalwane, you are blessed tonight. I hope, Mzalwane, you are strengthened. I hope, Mzalwane, you are ready. I hope, Mzalwane, you are focused to go forward. It comes through telling your mind. It comes through communicating with your mind. The woman with the issue of blood, I love it. The Bible says that she had been saying to herself, you need to tell yourself, Mzalwane, that I am out of the storm and I am going for victory. I am going to overcome. I am going for what is mine. You need to stand up, Mzalwane. Nobody will bring what is yours to you. You need to go for it, Mzalwane. You need to take some action. Like I spoke about Isaac. Isaac, when he heard that the Lord said, I will bless you, he did not wait for manna to fall from heaven, but he got down to work. And I want to say to him, Mzalwane, get down to work. You are across. You are on the other side. This is the time to get down to work, to worship the Lord, to glorify him. This is the time of celebrating. But you need to acknowledge it. If you do not acknowledge it, Mzalwane, you will see it. But you will not partake of it. That is very, very delicate. You will see it, Mzalwane, but you will not partake of it. We need to partake of what the Lord has prepared for us. God has got great things. God, after this storm, God wants to show himself a great God. God that is beyond any storm. COVID-19 is nothing to him. God wants to show himself a great God by blessing his children. But his children have to have their eyes opened to see what the Lord is doing. If we close our eyes and we choose to sleep, Mzalwane, I can assure you, we will not get anything. We will see it, but not partake of it. And I don't want to be part of that, Mzalwane. I've made a decision and I'm busy. I'm down to work and I'm seeing the goodness of the Lord in my life. And I want to say to you, Mzalwane, you are blessed and highly favored. The Lord is with you. You are purchased by the precious blood of Jesus Christ. You have been set for great things. You have been set for powerful things. It's a new season in your life, Mzalwane. But you need to acknowledge it. You need to stand up. You need, you know, to see what you have in your house, Mzalwane. I hope you have been blessed. I have been blessed myself. And I hope you are blessed. And I thank God for my spiritual parents who gave me this opportunity to share with you. And I'm going to pray with you. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, King of Kings. We thank you, Lord of Lords, for your goodness, your greatness, your love. You continue, Lord, for the past few months you've been talking to us, opening our eyes to realize that, hey, you are no longer in the storm, but you have crossed over. Opening our eyes to see that you've got great things that are lined up for us across the seas. We thank you, Father, that you have brought us across. And Lord, we give you the glory, the honor, and the adoration, Lord. We thank you for the service tonight. And I believe, my God, that we have, my brothers and sisters have been encouraged, have been strengthened, oh God. Thank you, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I glorify your name. I exalt your name. Hey, my brother and my sister, meet you at the top. That is where you belong. Greatness is in you because there's a greater God in you than the devil that is out there in the world. You are an overcomer, Mzalwane. Rise up, pagama Mzalwane, pagama, and make it happen. God bless you. In Jesus' name, amen.